Friends, how are you? Today was a complicated day for many adult life reasons. And to make this day more complex, even more complicated, was this segmentation fault from Redis while I was implementing vector sets changes. The interesting thing is that, if I remember correctly, this is the first time in about 2 months of work to vector sets that I get a segmentation fault. But it was not the right day to get segmentation faults. It was after a refactoring. By the way, no new feature, nothing like that. I just did a refactoring, then executed my nice test, and here, yeah, in this test here, there was the bug. This is what I refactored. So this is my node, my HNSW node. And the node is linked. It's linked at different layers. It has dense linking at layer 0, less link, more coarse links at other layers. And for each of these layers, I want to remember 2 things. The worst, basically, I want to remember which is right now the worst link in terms of distance, the most distant link. Why this is useful? It is useful because when I add a new node, node addition works like that. I collect a set of candidate neighbors for my new node, and then I want to link to such nodes. However, if the candidate is already full, and this is otherwise a good node for linking, but if it is already full, I want to replace one of its links only if my node is more near than its worst link. Otherwise, I'm in some way ruining the quality of the connections of this target node. So normally, I try to check, is my new connection, if I replace the worst distance, also good for my potential neighbor? If so, I link. Otherwise, normally I don't link. However, sometimes when I add nodes, I switch from aggressiveness 0, which is the behavior that I just exposed, to aggressiveness 1 or 2, which relax certain checks. Otherwise, sometimes my node would end without enough connections. If you are familiar with other HNSW implementations, perhaps you are asking yourself why it is possible. Anyway, you have your links and just you link to such nodes, and you don't have problems even if you cannot get a backlink. My implementation is different in this regard, because it forces links to have bidirectional connections, because I implement two deletion of nodes, and so I have to resolve my neighbors in order to also unlink them and so forth. In order to make this check, it is very important to cache what is right now the worst link that I have. Otherwise, every time I want to consider a node for linking, I would have to scan and compute the very, very hard to compute distance and so forth. And that would be bad. However, in the implementation that I had, this fixing on the worst neighbor was always ad hoc. Here I update and I have a bit of code that does it, and in this other place I also have some specific code which is a duplication of the previous code in order to fix, and so forth. I wanted to refactor this mess into something better. So basically, I implemented these new functions. One is called HNSW update worst neighbor, and it just performs a full scan, finding a way in which is the worst link after some kind of update, and refreshing the information completely from scratch. This also handles the case of numlinks equal to zero, because I initialize it's to zero, and I set it there. However, when I add a new link and when I delete a new link, which is normally the moment when I want to update the worst link information, I can do better than a full scan, because this is very costly in terms of CPU time. So I have a function which is specialized in updating the worst neighbor when a link is added. And what it does is, only if what I'm adding is worse than the current worst, I update the information. Otherwise, the old worst is okay, and I have to do nothing. Even more interesting is what happens when I remove a link. Basically, if I remove the old worst, I have to perform a full scan, because I don't know what is the penultimate worst. Okay. And also, if link I removed is before the index of the old worst link, which is still the worst link, by the way, I have to fix the index, because everything shifted one position, and I have to decrement my worst index by one. So let's look what is the effect of all this in the code. All this shit here becomes one liner. Even more interesting here, all this stuff here, it's just one liner, and so forth. Other cases of links added, which are much more easy to maintain later. So this was absolutely a needed change. However, as soon as I you see here, there is a very similar optimization. If it's the worst link, I recalculate it, otherwise I just shift one position, and so forth. So it's totally duplicated. All fine, but then I executed the test, segmentation fault. Before starting a long debugging session, I thought, let's try with Claude. Let's see if this AI can help also in this specific instance. So I pushed my implementation and my patch. Look at this, I stress this in every video I make about this coding with AI. It's very important to provide as fast as possible the right context. So the stack trace I got from Redis, the full implementation, what is the difference compared to the old one? Because if I was less experienced at working with LLMs, I could just drop the implementation here saying it crashes, let's check what it is. However, here I'm providing the code and it has the version, the difference. So it knows the version of the code when it was correct and the version of the code modified with the bug. And I very politely asked, I modified my HNSW implementation to refactor the worst node ID cleanup. Please identify errors in the patch, since now I have a regression segmentation fault. So I clearly stated that before there was no bug, now there is the bug. Make sure that the invariant that the worst index can never be out. So I provided some hints here and the stack trace. Let me analyze the patch and the code step by step to identify the potential issues. First, let's look at where the segmentation fault occurs. So it immediately realizes it is a null pointer dereference. Looking at the change, three new functions were introduced, and in HNSW update was negative. Basically, it identified immediately that this was missing. I'm not sure if it immediately created any problem, but it is correct that this code should be here. Basically, I forgot to add this code, but if we remain with zero links, we should set it to a safe zero. Okay, this is trivial, but still useful. So I said, great catch, but after implementing this change, it still crashes. Please try to find another bug that may have similar effects. So this was not a bug, but it was immediately obvious that was not it. And then it immediately realized, I noticed something critical. We are never actually replacing the worst link with the new node in the neighbor. The old code had, basically what I did here, I wanted to replace this line here with the new call, and instead I removed also this line here. I will show you. So in the patch, let's find it. Exactly. That's what I did here. Instead of just removing the old instance updating, I basically cleared the replacement of the past worst link with my new node. So it was everything was broken, basically. And then, yeah, I called my function. And it immediately find my bug, which was awesome. I fixed it and everything was running as expected. And this is basically the fix. So I tried to stress it a bit. This fixed the bug, I said, yet please find if there is any other similar bug. So at this point, if we are for the free lunch, let's free lunch. And it said, let me look through other similar operations in the code. I'll focus on places where links are modified and worse in index is involved. Looking at HNSW reconnect nodes, I found a similar pattern. This looks correct. However, I found another potential issue in HNSW unlinked node. He claimed that the pattern is similar. However, we should verify that J is equal to worst index, but I realized that this was not a problem. So I told to verify that there is a bug, do the thinking to check what happens exactly if J is the worst index. I believe this will trigger a full scan. Let me think, blah, 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 blah. Actually, I realized I was wrong. This is working correctly. So basically, what was potentially 1 hour of the bug? Because these stupid bugs where you remove a line accidentally, sometimes in complex data structures where reproducing again the things is hard, and also even when you have a code to reproduce exactly the bug, sometimes the bug is caused by 100 nodes modification ago, so it's complicated, time consuming. This was very cool, very very cool. And that's it, basically. Yeah, here what I'm doing basically in this branch, node updates, this was not related to the refactoring that I needed to do, was to implement the fact that the V8 add command, like other Redis set commands, if the node is if the element is already there, it gets updated and just the vector is modified. However, there is a very interesting thing here. Yeah. I wrote a function in order to optimize this, because how do you update a node like that if the same element is added again with a different vector? Normally, you remove the old node and add a new node. However, sometimes the new vector could be very near the old one. So maybe the neighbors that it has are good enough, and you can just take your node, don't calculate the instances, update the vector, and bye-bye, that's it. So I wrote this function, which I am currently not using. So I'm currently just doing the vanilla delete node, re-add node, which tries to understand if we can use the node if we have this new vector here. What happens basically is that we compute the old distances, and then we sort them, and then we use this 25% worst distances, the average, as a quality check for the new vector. So if the new vector has an average distance with the nodes which makes 50% of them pass this worst 25% distance, then we accept it. However, there is a problem with this, so I was not able to use this metric, and I will update it. If I do this the first time and I update it, it's okay, because the first neighbors were quality neighbors added when the node was added. However, after I update, I have the same old set of neighbors with a new vector, and maybe just we drifted a bit. So the next time when I will check again if I can update the vector, the node with a new vector, maybe this new vector is a bit far away again. However, since now the average distance is drifted, we will accept it, and we drift, and this ends to be a very bad thing. How this can be fixed? I put here a comment to remember myself. This function needs improvements. Successive updates to the same node with more and more distant vectors will make the node drift away from its neighbors. One of the additional metrics used could be neighbor to neighbor distance. That represents a more absolute check of fit for the new vector. So basically, I also can compute which is the average distance among the vectors, and if my node is drifting too much, I will see that it will start to have a distance which is far away the distance that my neighbors have between them. Okay, thanks for following. Bye.